go to the Facebook, to their Facebook. You can enter the contest and win that keyboard, and they'll ship it out to you. And it's a really nice mechanical keyboard, A, and then B, it's signed by all of these great pros. I mean, Golden Light, Inori, Dream Monster, Tails, Clyde, Alicia, Ryung, Illusion, The Ognis, Sleep, Violet, Insur, Huan Sing, and Rhythm. Like, how much better does it get than that? That's what I want to know.
Yeah, it really can't. I mean, yep, those were phenomenal names. All those players, very top-notch. And, yeah, go win a keyboard, guys.
Go win like, a really nice mechanical keyboard.
Yeah, mechanical keyboard. Mechanical keyboards are very nice.
They are.
But we do have the next map. It is going to be Cloud Kingdom.
Yep.
And I like this choice.
Tell me about it.
I mean, it's Protoss. You get that fast third base. This is the map that the Sentry Immortal style first started on. It became really popular on this map. Mm-hmm. You wall off that third base with the gateways. You get cannons down. You get the Sentry Immortals. You expand. Then you eventually get the Colossus and the Blinkstalkers. And a lot of Protoss players feel very, very comfortable on this. And this map is very similar to the way, kind of a way Atiga and Entomb work, except instead of not being able to get a fast fourth, where does Zerg take a fifth? It's very hard. You can deny the fifth very easily. So if you're going for the late game, where you get your third base and your fourth base is Protoss, it's really difficult for Zerg to, you know, bust through.
It's true, man. It is true. It looks like Real is ready to go, waiting on Death Angel to be ready as well for admins to get everything done. But I agree with you. I mean, it's one of those maps where, you know, the other thing to note on this map is that the natural to the third base, that pushing distance for the Protoss or the Zerg is very short, Zoya.
Yeah.
And there's actually, I'm trying to remember the name of the Zerg, but there's a Zerg who really likes to do a very aggro style where he goes Roach Hydra in a lot of his pushes. Maybe you remember who I'm talking about. But this map is like his favorite map ever because the pushing distance is so short. That he can really just kind of like push in across the map with Roach Hydra and like kill off Protosses. It's kind of crazy. It's kind of good.
I don't.
Do you know which Zerg I'm talking about?
No.
No.
Who you're talking about?
I don't remember.
I don't think I've ever seen Roach Hydra on this map.
Oh, yeah, this guy does it all the time. Is it Daisuke?
It might be.
Yeah, I think
so. Sounds like something he'd do. He's weird like that.
Yep. We're waiting on Death Angel still once again. Did win that last game, but wants to take a short break before he gets into the next game.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes you just need to calm yourself down after a big win like that. Real's a really good player, and taking them down like that looked almost one-sided, and you gotta not get cocky. You gotta keep your head in the game. You gotta keep calm.
Yep. Don't wanna get cocky. You wanna stay calm. Be like, well, that was good, but gotta knock it out. So let's talk about these groups a little bit, Zoya. While we've got some time, so I'm gonna pull those up on the screen. And I mean, I think the big things to note here is that we're in Group A right now, which is of course Sleep, Real, Select, and Death Angel. And right now, Death Angel's looking pretty good over Real. And I mean, if I had to call this group for people getting out of the group, I want to say Sleep Select.
Yeah.
But Real is kind of a threat, but I don't know. I mean, Death Angel played really well in that last match.
This is definitely, I know those are the group votes got Group D as the group of death, but
I don't think Group D is the
trolling. I think that was like 100% trolling.
I don't understand how.
I think Group A is the group of death. Maybe Group C, because Daisy's kind of this guy that came out of nowhere.
And there's Todd and Golden in there as well. Yeah. And I mean, State is one of those players who could just come out and do anything. Yep. Could just, like, come out of nowhere and do anything. But, guys, we're going to jump into the next match. I'm excited, so I hope you're excited as well.
Yeah, this group's sick, man. I can't wait. I can't wait to see who wins this game. It's going to be rough. But Cloud Kingdom, like we talked about, will we see the same style from before, or what is going to be really Death Angel's choice here? Because last game he went for the blind three hatch. Will he do it again?
Yep, we will have to see. And jumping on in, I need to see, do I have the scoreboard right? I think the answer is no. I tried to get it right.
I don't know.
Tried to get it right, but Zoya, go ahead and intro our players.
Yeah, spawning in the bottom left-hand corner of the map as the Green Zerg, currently up 1-0. Will he be able to close the series now? We have Death Angel and his opponent in the top right-hand corner of the map as the Red Protoss. Probably more favored to win this group than his opponent. Will he be able to turn it around and bring it to an ace match? We have Real.
We certainly do. So we'll have to see, you know, what he can pull out here, if he can make it happen. But I'm going to go ahead and fix that score for everyone. I apologize. It is hard running the stream, casting, observing, and updating everything at the same time. I don't have Luca here to do it for me.
Luca is a big help. He's a big help. Now, we do actually have Real scouting this time with that probe. Going for the 9 scout. Might be still going for Nexus first, but that hasn't been shown just yet. He is actually opting the scout this time, opposed to last game. Doing a little bit of probe harassment here, being as annoying as possible.
Yeah, I mean, and that's great. It's one of those things where, you know, you come in and you try and be as annoying as possible, and it's just to kind of throw your opponent off, because it's really easy when you're playing any race to have your fingers kind of go into autopilot, where you're like, well, okay, I'm just going to keep making drones, and then you're like, oh, well, I didn't actually get my pool down at 14 food, so I guess I'll have to do a 15 pool, and then the pool's late, and then the pylon block does more damage because of it, and it can just get kind of messy real quickly. So
we are seeing a Nexus first from Real.
Yep.
On 15, opposed to the 16 or 17 that most Protoss players do, want to get that down as quick as possible.
Did
get that
see
forge
a
down quickly.
17 Nexus last game.
Yeah.
And then a 17 Forge. So this is a much earlier Forge. But on this map, I think this is appropriate because this is a much smaller map. You know, it's one of those maps where the run distance for the Lings is much shorter. And he did see a pool first build this game. So it was pool and then hatch. No gas down for the Zerg player yet. We might see that if he's going to go for something big and aggressive, but I don't know a whole lot about Death Angel's playstyle, so, I mean, that could be exactly what he's going for. I can't tell you.
Yeah, we'll have to see. And this goes back to, like, what you said in the map. Mm-hmm. You can't do the same builds. Daybreak is so huge, you can't really get away with that kind of play on this map. If it gets scouted, you can punish it so much easier, just because this map may look big, but it's actually, this rush distance is not that far at all.
Yep.
We do have Lings moving on the map. It does force this probe to move away from that Xel'Naga tower. Nice timing there from Real. He's going to go scout the third base, make sure that is not being taken.
Yep.
Scouting the fourth as well, just making sure nothing crazy is going on here.
Yeah, I mean, and coming up to the third and verifying that the third is, in fact, there, like you mentioned, is so important, because it's one of those things. It's like, you can't get into the main to see if there's gas taken in the main anymore as the Protoss player, because the Queens are just so good at denying scouting with that increased range. So it puts you in a position as the Protoss player where you're playing blind until you can get an observer out, or until you, you know, not so much get an observer, but push out with some units and force the Zerg's hand to show them what you have, or show you what they have, rather. Oh, but I love this Cybernetics Core positioning on the high ground. Look at this out of Real. This is so smart, Zoya, because now if you take a look at this, if Zerglings come to the front, they cannot check to see if Chronos are being spent on that Cybercore. They cannot check to see when it stops spinning. All they can check on is that front gateway and just the Forge.
Yeah, beautiful. I believe the first person I saw do this was Creator Prime. I don't know if he's actually the first person that done it on this map, but for the longest time, people were just using the three building wall off on this map, not wanting to risk any form of all-in. I'm just completely sealing it. But now we're seeing this Cybernetics Core on the high ground, and it's very smart. Everything about you said is just...
this is really interesting, though. I want to point out what Real's doing. He's not mining gas at all, and he actually just got enough gas to start plus one and warp gate. And he's making zealots, and then adding a third gas at the natural, but still not mining out of gas. So I'm really kind of curious as to what he's up to. This, I don't know, man.
It's going to be the zealot pressure. How many gates he throws down? There it goes. So we're going to see a lot of zealots warping.
Yeah, this is going to be so many zealots.
So fast. He's been chrono boosting warp gate. He's been chrono boosting for the forge, getting out that plus one. It's going to be a very fast 7-8. This is a very all-in-ish type build.
Wow.
I've seen this style before, I would not be surprised if he followed up with Stargate and just started mixing in Void Rays as well, because the Zealots are just going to devour those queens. They're going to be throwing down spine collars, and then you follow up with Void Rays. I believe I saw a Nori do this once during the Gigabyte Esports LAN, and it's an insane
build. I don't doubt it. It's really harsh. Now, Death Angel does know about this pylon finishing up down here at the bottom. He did see that. But, I mean, Real is just throwing down a ton of pylons on his way over. And, I mean, it's important to note what you said there, is that this comes at a timing which most Zerg players are not expecting aggression at. I mean, if we look at this, Warpgate has finished up, Plus One has just finished up, he's warping in a ton of Stalkers with that gas that he just got, he's got that Plus One, the Roachhorn isn't even done yet, Zoya, and this is going to be so rough, he has to pull drones, I don't think he's going to be able to hold this, Zoya!
Drones are attacking these Zealots right now. Ling's coming forward as well. Speed's not done. The Roachhorn isn't finished. So many slow Lings are popping out here. They don't have any upgrades. So these Zealots are going to two-shot them.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if he's going to hold this. I think you're right. Real is going to do so much damage here. But if he does hold, even if he loses the natural base, as long as he maintains most of his drone count, this can go back into a normal game. And Death Angel might come on top, but I don't even know if he's going to be able to hold. This is
I mean, this is so many... Stalkers and Zerglings here pushing forward, doing a ton of damage to this third base. Now, I mean, the Zealots are getting cleaned up as the Roaches are helping that, but he has lost a lot of drones so far in this attack, 18 to be exact. So beautiful aggression out of Real, and this might buy him the game.
It all depends on how much damage he takes. If he loses the third base, he'll be able to make some form of a comeback. But if it goes anything further than that, because if you look at that income tab, even though he lost a lot of drones, it's still 42 to 40. He still has the Harvester lead. So if he can somehow hold with this micro from Real, it's so spot on. But the Roaches, I mean, they're just doing too much. And with the reinforcing, I think that Death Angel might even save the third.
He might be able to save the third. He has lost a lot of drones. He's actually starting to produce drones again, which, I mean... I guess, you know, he's probably okay in this sort of situation, but with the number of gates Protoss has, this is actually quite scary. He's banking a lot of gas as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if he spends his next couple warp-ins rounds on sentries, which I think would be a good idea.
We'll have to see what's going on. I mean, it looks like this. We might actually even be GG very soon here from Real. This is just too much. Death Angel has way too many Roaches. He's micro these Roaches so beautifully here. He's constantly reinforcing. Eight more are about to pop out. The third base might just barely fall. I really wish he would have built a couple spines in his natural and transferred them over, but it looks like this third base should fall. The Roach reinforcements are just too strong, though.
Oh, that third is so low. You are right, Zoya, but I mean, this beautiful dance that both these players are doing at this third base, I mean, the control on the Stalkers has been great. The third finally goes down, and now Real decides it is time to pull back, so he's pulling back, waiting for those Broodlings to expire. And, I mean, this kind of puts our Zerg player in a little bit of an awkward position, because, you know, I mean, if we take a look at things, like, he's got 45 drones to the 41 probes of his opponent. Granted, he's got 19 Roaches on the field, and he's making more, but... I mean, if he tries to all in, there should be enough gas and enough warp-ins to do sentries for days, man.
Well, I don't think he should all in. Zergs have gotten better at this. I've learned it myself as well while playing on the Crane server. When I lose my third, if I hold to an all-in like this, I can come back and it'll turn into a normal game. So as long as he gets his lair, he throws down those evolution chambers, he retakes his third, starts droning up again, I mean, this should just transition into a pretty normal game. I mean, Real invested a lot into that push.
Oh, yeah. No, he certainly did.
Even in the units lost tab, you do see that Death Angel did lose more, but the income tab's relatively the same. So it just depends on what the follow-up is here from Death Angel.
Yeah, I am kind of curious to see, you know, what both these players are going to make happen. Plus two on the way, Blink on the way, the Robotics as well. But here comes a little bit of aggression out of the Zerg. I think there are enough sentries here to kind of nullify this pressure. But he's going after that Forge. He's going to kill off that plus two, and that's greatly going to delay that upgrade. And further just throw resources back in the bank of Real, who is having a little bit of trouble spending all of his gas right now.
Yeah, he was mining a little bit too much gas there, as you pointed out. He had banked so much. Right now he's floating 700 gas to like 300 minerals. This is a bit ridiculous. He is getting Blink. He's rebuilding that forge. He's got the robotics facility on the way. This is a really weird situation. What he needs to do is just get that century count higher and try and secure a third at this point.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I mean, he's got so much gas. If he just warps in a few rounds of sentries, he's actually going to be able to expend it all. I mean, with that many gates on the field, I mean, especially, what is that, 7 that he has out now. So, and those sentries are so critical in this matchup, and especially on this map, at just kind of keeping...